everybody, welcome back to Trinity Dairy. Don't forget to like and share the video, subscribe to the channel, check out our merch store. We'll have a link in the description for that. You can also follow us on Facebook and Instagram. Today's June 19th, 2023. It's my birthday today, so you can leave your guess in the comments of how old you think I am. It's pretty nice out. It's supposed to be hot the next few days, up in the 90s or low 90s, I guess. We did get a little bit of rain. We got about 2/10 of rain last night, which wasn't a lot, but it was much needed and much appreciated, that's for sure. Should get some of the corn. Some of the corn, it was so dry, hasn't even germinated yet, so hopefully it'll get some of that rolling anyway. What we're working on today, or at least right now, I've got our Gehl, the newer Gehl skid loader, the 4625, pulled up in front of the barn here. I've got the belly pan pulled off of it. I'm going to flip the cab up, take the pressure washer, clean it all out. For one reason, because they get full of hay, silage, dirt, all that kind of stuff, and they're can be a big fire hazard. But the main reason, or the second reason, I guess I'm doing it, not necessarily the main reason, it's got a hydraulic leak under there somewhere, so I need to flip the cab up, and I'm assuming it's a hose or something that's starting to leak. So flip the cab up, clean it out, and get in there and see what's going on there. Well, this cab is pretty easy to flip up. I've got the cordless impact with a swivel and a 3/4 inch socket. In each front corner here, there's a bolt in this little pocket, one on each side. Pull them out, and then it just flips right up over. You want to make sure that you don't have any wrenches or anything sitting in there under the seat, because when you flip that up, all that stuff will fall back against the back window, and you don't want to break that. So that's something to always keep an eye on. And we've gone through and checked, and seemed to got everything out of there. I don't think there's anything, didn't look like anything under the seat, so we should be good. So I'm gonna buzz these bolts out and flip it up. Working on the skid steer. It's got an oil leak somewhere.
You stay back, okay? In case something falls.
Okay. Well, there it is, all flipped up. I guess it does have a lock on there. I forgot about that. That's where the lock's up, so I don't have to brace it. You can see how dirty it gets and stuff in here. There's all kinds of crud. Nothing but a fire hazard. Get that all washed out of there and see if I can spot where my leak is. So we'll get the washer hooked up and start washing. Uh-huh. I got it hosed off pretty good here. I found my leak, and I've taken it apart a little bit, kind of dug into it. I thought maybe it was a hose, but it's not. So what's under here? Okay, so we've got our steering valves and everything under here and the pumps. So there's a, get this camera down in here. So there's this shaft here coming up out of this, and this would go over the shaft, and that's for your steering. It turns the valve in there, and that's the seal that's leaking. I'm not sure what kind of a seal, if it's a special seal or an O-ring or what, but it's got this little tin cover. It's got a couple of Torx head screws on there, so I'm going to pull those out and lift that cover off. There's a key in here too, and that, what the key does is there's grooves in here, so this key can line up in there when you put that back on. So I'm going to pull that little cover off, and we'll see what we find in there. All right, so I got the two screws and the key out of there. Now we'll lift that little cover off and see what we're dealing with in here. Okay, looks like just a seal in there. I could pull this top cover off here, but I think that's what holds the whole pump and everything up, so I'm not sure if I should pull that off, because it's gonna put a lot of stress on there. I don't think I really need to. I'm gonna try to see if I can get a number off of that seal, so I can get one ordered before I pull it apart, so I can still use this thing if I need to. All right, well, we're back to our regularly scheduled program here. I'll give you an update of what's going on. I couldn't get my camera to come back on. I think it was overheating. So anyway, I got the old seal pulled out. I couldn't read the number off of it, so I took a screwdriver and I hooked the outside edge, and it popped right out. And so this is it here. The number that's on it is a 16253-16NC. I don't know if that is a Gehl number or not. If any of you want to replace this, you could try calling Gehl with that number. The seal that I replaced, or that I got, I had to pull it out because I had to take it uptown to, they had to measure it because that number didn't register at the parts store. So I got a CR brand seal, and that's a 9935. That come out with the right measurement, so we'll see how it works. But if you're going to do this, I would recommend getting the seal ahead of time if one of these numbers will work for you. Because when you pull that seal out, it is constantly has a little bit of oil leaking up out of there. I got something under there to catch it while I had to run to town to get the seal. But it does do that. So if you had a seal sitting here, you could pop right in, would be better. I could have ordered one from Gehl, but that's going to be a few days to get. And since I had this all apart, I thought if I could get one in town, you know, that'd be the way to go. So we'll see if we can get it put back in here. Get a little oil and oil up the seal. I will have to get something to tap that down in there a little bit. I keep running into a little bit of a snag trying to get this pushed in all the way, because there is oil. I suppose the gravity from the tank is pushing up on it yet. If I tap down on this side of the seal, it wants to just pop this up. It keeps rocking the seal.
and you can't get straight down from the top with this frame on here. And I don't know if I want to bother pulling that frame off or not. So I think what I'm going to do is put this tin cover back over it and get the screws started. And then I can kind of tap on this tin cover. And that should help keep it from rocking out of there, I'm thinking. So we'll see if that works. That helps us out at all. Alright, I snugged that up a little. Now I can try tapping on it. Now I gotta try to not drop this key down in the dirt. It's on there, so I'll put this on. This bolt back in and
put the yellow thing part of the yellow key there.
What thing?
The yellow thing on that.
Oh, I was to just move some oil. All right, well, we got it all back together. I put some hydraulic oil in it. It's not completely full, but I didn't want to fill it completely up in case it was still leaking and I have to take it apart again. Just in case you lose some, or if it's leaking really bad so it pumps everything out. But I figured I'd fire it up now. I'll drive it around a couple times and we'll flip the cab up and see if it's leaking. All right, I got it pulled over here in the shade. I just flipped the cab up again. After driving it around a little bit, let's see if it's leaking. And it doesn't look like it. Before, it would always run right back down here and was running down the side of the pump or whatever there. I'll check the other side. No, looks good. Don't see any leaking, so I guess I can fill it back up with hydraulic oil. I'll let the boom down, so there really shouldn't be any extra oil in there because that should just exchange out of the cylinders. But then we'll fill her up and hopefully it's good to go. I was going to change the engine oil on it today too, but it's getting to be about chore time now, so I'll save that job for another day. But I got it all pressure washed out anyway, so got a little one repair done on the list of many, but hope you enjoyed the video and we'll see you in the next one.